Number 12, I was talking about the first part of this question number 1, okay, wherein we need to capture the network packets originating from your system, right? So I was asking how to proceed for this question. Any idea? Anyone can tell? Send from your system, right? So first of all, we need to find out our own system's IP address, right? So how can you find out? You can simply open the command prompt, right? And then there you can write ipconfig command. Okay, from there you can gather your IP address of your system, right? And so now this is open. Here I am opening this interface, which is Wi-Fi, as I am getting some network traffic over here, right? This type of graph you can see that is continuously changing, right? So I want to monitor the traffic over this network. So I'll click on here, right? Now you can see this packet capturing has already started and the packets are being captured, right? On this interface, you can see more than 2000 packets are captured, 3000, right? It is going very fast. Now what I'll do, I will just stop capturing the packets, okay? And then I'll apply the filter on this saved file. Right. So as in the question number 1, it has been asked all the packets originating from your computer. So basically I need to apply filter. Simple filter you apply, right? The filter is ip.addr, right? And is equals you need to write the your system's IP address. So here we need to write, you can see this is the system's IP address, so 192 for you, you need to write your IP system IP address, right? 168.1.107, right? Correct. So we have written the command correctly. That's what it is appearing in green color, right? Press enter. So now you will see all the packets, okay, which are basically here. This is giving all the packets, okay, for which either the source IP address is this or the destination IP address similar to this one, which I have entered on this bar, right? But we are we need to find out the packets which are originating from our system, right? So for that I need to write a command so that all the packets for which source IP address is similar to this one, okay, should appear over here. As you can see here, we can see the third packet, okay. Here source IP address is different, okay, which is also, but here you can see the destination IP address is same as which I have entered over here. That's what it is appearing in this first subsection, right? So what we need to do over here, we need to simply write src, okay? ip.source means source IP address is this one, okay? Display all the packets for which source IP address is the same as written over here, right? Just press enter. Press enter means just apply this filter, okay? So now you can check all the packets which will appear over here will be having the source IP address similar to this one, okay? Is it clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so now coming to the question number 2. Here basically display the two protocols, okay, HTTP and TCP, okay, and corresponding network packets. So basically we need to filter two protocol packets, okay, simultaneously. Means the packets from HTTP packets as well as the TCP packets, okay. So how we can proceed for that? So here again we need to apply some filter. So first of all we need to clear this. I will just close this, and here we need to adhere, right? So here we require HTTP, right? So first check whether any HTTP packets are captured or not. So you can see there is no HTTP packets are there, right? Okay, let's see TCP packets. So TCP packets are there, right? But there is no HTTP packets. So, but if you it means in this trace file, okay, which I have captured, there is no which I have saved, sorry, which I have saved, there is no what you call HTTP packets are captured, right? So here basically, suppose some of the HTTP packets are also captured in this file itself. So then we can simply write the command TCP or HTTP. Okay, in that case, both the what you call packets will get appear. Okay, TCP as well as HTTP. So now we need to first find out this packet. We need to capture this HTTP packets also. Okay, so basically what we need to do, we need to basically browse some websites. Okay, we need to send some HTTP requests. Right. Here you can see these are the HTTP only, and we can check from which site these packets are basically captured, right? So lots of detail is available over here, okay, that you can simply explore and you can find out, right? So this is Chrome is there, and accept application HTML. Okay, lots of fields are there, images, web images. Okay, so some of the images which I have requested, okay, that is available over there. Okay, so these two packets, and if you want to see more detail about these packets, you can simply go to this second subsection and you can open this also, right? So here host is google.com, and here other details is details are also available, right? So this is HTTP request packet, right? Is it clear? Now if you apply the filter or TCP, okay, then you can find both the packets, right? Means TCP as well as HTTP, because HTTP are very few. Okay, that's what you need to check where it is appearing, maybe at the end only. Because okay, very few you can search, okay, it will be available here only. Otherwise what you can do, you can change the coloring rules also, okay, for HTTP, then you can immediately identify. Okay, is it clear? Any doubt? You can see this HTTP packet. Okay, here this is HTTP get HTTP 1.1. okay, so okay, let's stop this, and now moving for the next question, wherein we need to capture some of the packets, okay, all the packets associated with a specific port number, right? And port number, it may be a source port or the destination port. Okay, so for that purpose we need to apply a different filter, right? So here we can write tcp.port, and port is equals to, you can write any port number, as we have already discussed, the port is port number, or you can say port address is a 16 bit length address, right? So the range is from 0 to 2 to the power 16 minus 1, right? So here let's suppose take 443, right? So 443 is a secure, or you can say SSL protocol, which it uses. Okay, so I have applied, and you have applied tcp.port is equals to 443. Okay, so you can check also all these packets basically are related to either these packets basically are you can say either source port is 443 or the destination port is 443. Okay, for these packets, so you can check it from here. Okay, if you want to see the detail, so first packet I have selected here, I'll go to transmission control protocol, and here you can check source port is 61784, right, and destination port is 443, right? If you want to what you call capture the packets, okay, from means for which the source port is 443, okay, only the packets for which source port is 443, so you can change this also, right? So let's check whether it is available or not. If I'll write TCP dot source port, right, and then press enter. Okay, so I am getting the results over here, and you can see all the packets which I am selecting for all the packets. Source port is 443 only, right? Are you getting my point? So if you are writing TCP dot port, then it will give you the same port number. This port number. Same as either as what you call source port or the destination port. Okay, but if you write TCP dot source port, then all the packets will appear for which the source port number is same as 443. Okay, right. So first you can see this subsection gives you the packet list, second packet details, and third packet bytes. Okay. So I hope this is clear to all of you. You can change the port number also, and you can check what are the other packets you are getting over here. Okay. So now coming to the next part, which is display all the packets with TCP problems, right? So what type of problems may be there? Yeah, it may be related to a window size, right? Maybe there is an update in the source as well as the receiver's window size. Okay. Or anyone's means either from the source window size or the receiver's window size, or there is a loss of acknowledgement, okay, or there is a segment itself not properly captured, okay. So in all these cases, basically there will be a what you call the packets, okay, TCP packet, okay, with some error will get displayed, right? So how we can capture those packets? So to do that, we need to apply a different filter, right? So basically, we are looking for all those packets, okay, with TCP problems, right? So basically, what we can write in this, basically, we need to analyze those packets, okay? And then if there is some problem in the packet, then it's flagged. Okay, so if you see the TCP header structure, right? So you will see different types of flag, right? Flag bits also. So those bits basically will be updated, or there will be a change. So we need to analyze those flag bits. Okay, so I will write over here TCP dot analysis. Okay, dot flags, right? Is it clear? And then press enter. So now you can check. So basically I'm using this default. Let me change this profile and use the default one. Okay, so that will be more clear, because everything is appearing blue background, right? There I have made some customization. So here you can see these are the packets, TCP packets with TCP problems. So here first one, you can say this is TCP retransmission, right? From this source port to destination port, okay? And then other type of error, you can say TCP out of order is there, right? And this is another type of error, or you can say TCP problem, which is previous segment not captured. Okay, and then you can check other here a duplicate acknowledgement is received, right? So these are the some problems with these packets, right? So we can see all the packets and further analyze from this subsection, right? So you can further see the details, okay, more detail about these packets, right? So here you can see flag, here acknowledgement bit is there, right? If you change the other packets, so we are seeing only window size, right? Calculated window size, okay, but here flag is acknowledgement. So let's check. Okay, the first one, if you check, so here it is push as well as acknowledgement, right? Is it clear? So these are the basically flags, okay, which you can check will be available in TCP header, okay. So here basically Now moving to the other question, which is, okay, we have completed. Now we need to find out all the packets with SYN bit set to 1, okay, in TCP header. So as I told you, there are several flag bits, okay, in TCP header itself. So one of the bit is SYN bit, okay. SYN stands for synchronization, okay. So basically, whenever a three-way handshake is done, right, before sending the data, so this TCP protocol basically you can say a three-way handshake is done, okay, before sending or transmitting the data, okay. So what happens basically here, three steps are there, three you can say sub processes are there in three-way handshake. First is the connection establishment, right, and then data transmission, and then connection termination, okay. So in the connection establishment itself, this bit is or you can say this packet is being sent, okay, which one? SYN, okay. SYN is SYN bit is sent from the source to destination, right, and the destination send the, or you can say receiver send back SYN plus acknowledgement, right, to the source. And then from the source side, again, acknowledgement will be sent. So this will complete a connection establishment, right, step in three-way handshake. So now we need to find out all the packets with SYN bit set to 1. What we need to do, we need to simply apply a filter so that we can check all these packets, okay. So here we will simply write tcp.flex, right? tcp.flex. So because this is also a flag bit only, right, this SYN, so we need to find out all these things dot SYN. We will write SYN bit set to 1, okay. tcp.flag.SYN is equals 1, right, then press enter. So now you can check, right, so all these packets you can check here, basically SYN bit is there, okay, in all these packets, okay, either it is SYN or SYN with acknowledgement, right, all these packets. You can check the detail for further detail also, but just by expanding this TCP tab, okay. So here you will see the flag also, okay, flag is also set, and here SYN and acknowledgement is there, right. So SYN and acknowledgement is basically sent from the receiver to the source side while establishing a three-way handshake, okay, connection establishment in three-way handshake, right. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now coming to the next part. Okay, so here you can check another part also. Okay, here as I have applied tcp.flex.syn is equals to 1, you can see one more, what you call, if you want to display the packets with TCP resets. Okay, in those packets where some of the flags are reset, okay, in the trace file. So how can you find out those packets? So simply you need to write over here tcp.flag.reset, okay, and press enter. So you will see the packets, okay, wherein some of the flag bit is reset, right. So here basically you can check further, right, that detail also. So this is not means there is no question related to this particular command, okay. This is for your information only, okay. Now coming to the next part, here basically we need to display all the packets generated due to HTTP request, right. So how we can obtain all the packets, or we can capture the packets in Wireshark. So here we need to write a command http dot request, okay, http dot request. So you can see all these packets, okay, these are basically the http request packet, okay. How can you verify this? We can simply click on this any one of the packet, okay, and then you can explore over here. So here this is coming simple discovery, simple service discovery protocol. So here you can check, this is the HTTP request 1/4, right? Otherwise you can check this HTTP packet also, and here just open this, and again you can see the HTTP request 1/1, okay? And the further detail also you can check in this packet bytes, right? Okay, so here basically what you call all these packets, now we have obtained, right? These are basically showing all HTTP requests involved in trace file. Okay, now coming to the next part, which says display all the packets generated due to HTTP response with a specific code, right? And the code is also given as 200, suppose this is for example, right? So basically you have sent some request, okay, web request you can say, when you have browsed or you have opened a website google.com, right? So what you are basically sending, okay, you are sending a request to open this particular web page, okay, through a request. Now once this request will get received at the server side, okay, so if this is successful request, this request has been received by the server, okay, then what will happen, basically there will be a successful response code also, okay? So with each HTTP request there will be HTTP response status code also, right, which indicates whether a specific HTTP request has been successfully completed or not. Okay, if it is successfully completed, then the response code will vary from 200 to 299. Okay, if it is a client error type of request, right? So its status code will be from 400 to 499. Okay, likewise it varies. Okay, so these codes are predefined that you can check in the help section also, right? So now I'm interested in the HTTP response packets, right, with a status code as 200, right? So here basically I need to write a command, okay, HTTP dot response. Okay, sorry, here I have written something wrong. So HTTP, right? HTTP dot response dot code equals that code you need to write, suppose 200, right? So let's check. So any code, whether it is HTTP dot response. Okay, this. Okay, so here I am not getting any packet, right? So any one of you are getting any packet after applying this filter? Okay, so that will come since I have stopped it, maybe in the previous trace file that is not captured. Okay, so let's check. Okay, maybe Bennett I have opened, maybe some of the again I will try to browse, okay, and then check whether it is coming or not. Since I have already done, maybe that's what, it is not appearing, but it will come, right? So this is the code which you can apply. It will show all the HTTP response, right? Why it is not okay, let me just, okay, I have started. Okay, let me copy this, close this filter and check whether I am getting. Okay, in this file also. Okay, so since I am doing it maybe from the, okay, so as you said, let's open in this incognito mode. Okay, and here, okay.
Sir, try HTTP websites on Google.
Okay, so now I got, see, you can see these packets are now captured. Okay, so let me stop this at this point. So HTTP dot, okay, I was looking for a response. Okay, so I need to write dot response. Okay, code is equals to 200 and apply this filter. Okay, so still some packets are not appearing, right? But it should come, okay? Because in the previous lab, I have seen this will appear, okay? So this is the code which you can apply and it will appear in Wireshark, right? So HTTP packets are getting captured, only the problem with the maybe some of the what you call, let me again clear my cache, okay? Because
sir, that website has sent in the link, you can check that website.
Okay, which one?
Sir, in the chat I sent, in the chat, Teams chat.
Okay,
so this is HTTP website, it will give you code, 200 code.
Okay, okay. So here you have sent something, okay. epfindia.gov.in. Okay, so here it is coming, not secure, right? So it is using HTTP only, right? Not HTTPS. Now let's check. So you can see here the lots of packets are now captured. Okay, so these are the response HTTP packets with responses, right? So this way you can find out all these information, these packets you can capture, and you can check the status code also. Okay, so here 200 and here it is written okay. Okay, and you can check from here also, it will be available HTTP response. Okay, and code also you can check, it will be available over here, you can see from here. Okay, and other detail from this side means here you can basically check the what you call the URL also, you can check, okay, if it is available. Okay, let's close this. Now coming to the next part, which is basically display all the TCP packets sent to a specific URL. Okay, suppose you are interested in the packets, okay, which are sent to a specific URL, or you want to basically analyze some of the packets based on some keywords or text, right? So how you can find out? So here you need to apply a filter. Okay, let's stop this, otherwise the file size will be more, it will be large. So here basically I can apply the TCP, sorry, contains, not dot, okay, TCP space contains, right, and that keyword you can put, okay? So maybe YouTube, okay? So you can see these four packets, 3 to 5 packets are there, okay? Let's select one of the packet, and you can verify this also, okay? With this URL also you can see in the packet bytes, this is youtube.com, right? Similarly, other packets also. Okay, let's check with some other keyword. Apply Facebook. So, okay, so I got these many packets from Facebook also. Okay, so let's check one of the packet, and you can check the detail here, facebook.com, right? So this way you can obtain all these packets. You can capture, right? And now coming to the last part, okay, which is basically, we need to find all the packets received from a specific URL, okay? Means basically reply from these web URLs, right? Response packet, you can say. So basically, you can here, you can write slash UDP also, right? So basically, what we need to do over here, we need to make a slight change over here, then you will get all these response packets, right? So here I'll write UDP contains Facebook, okay, and then apply this filter. So you can see over here, this is I am getting these many packets over here, okay? So you can check also whether this is a response packet or not. Simply click on any one of the packet and go to maybe domain name system, right? And there, this is the query, right? This is the query, and the second one is the response. You can see over here response. So as you can see in this, this is the response, right? So what was the query? Query was basically standard query, and something is in aconnect.facebook.net. Okay, so for this web URL, what is the mapped IP address, right? Because we usually write a website name, okay? So but each web URL, or you can say with each domain name, okay, will be mapped with a IP address, okay, and which can be obtained through DNS, okay. So the main task of the DNS is to basically provide the IP address corresponding to a web URL, okay. So you can see over here domain and system. So what is the corresponding IP address, right, for this particular web URL, okay, for this particular domain name. So that will come, and then further query will be done, right? So here basically we got the packet, okay? So I hope I have completed all these questions, okay? Even I have completed all the questions, right? So in case if you are having any doubt, you can ask.